I said, hey, yo, what's good? And salute to all my YouTube land people in the building. Yes, welcome back to the channel and welcome back to another edition where I'm going to be speaking on the differences and why, in my opinion, I think that Kobe Bryant is indeed better than LeBron James. I have to make a part two, but before I even get to that, I hope all of you are doing well. I got a double feature for you guys today. So I got a little bit of this, and then I have another video, which I'm not gonna spoil what it is, but it's gonna be for the whole week. I'll get back to the gameplay next week as far as my daily rotation. But as far as for this right here, it's just gonna be, hold on, let me turn this music down a little bit. As far as for this, it's gonna be just, it's just gonna be just these videos. I'm not gonna do any of the main gameplays. Listen, it's football season, okay? It's NFL season, so I got a special NFL video for you all. But yeah, let's get right into it. Let's talk about it. Now, before we talk about it, let's see who we, because I got a video for y'all with this, so let me see volume two. Okay, so they got Kenya Martin, Yao, and Steve Francis. Alright, gonna go ahead and, I'll pick my three in a second. But anyway, let me go ahead and get right into it, okay? I don't want to waste anybody's time. First of all, thank you all for tuning in. Of course, thank you all for stopping by. Like I said, I know the last two videos are very controversial. You know, when I made that other video, like I said, I was just really tired of the disrespect and the phoniness. You know, and the lies and the withholding of truth when it comes to Kobe versus LeBron. And I didn't really touch on everything that I wanted to touch on. But as of right now, I have some time to, you know, talk about that. So as far as for when it comes to, you know, like I said, starting out, coming into the league, Kobe Bryant, see, this is what makes the debate a little bit weird and a little bit unfair to Kobe, because when he first came into the league, you know, like I said, he came out of high school, and a lot of high school players, you know, they had to make a name for themselves. And that's why, you know, LeBron James has a lot that is owed to guys like Kobe Bryant, Kevin Garnett, Jermaine O'Neal, Tracy McGrady, in that time period of the early 2000s, because, you know, they had, you know, a lot of players. Those players made a significant impact in the league by the time LeBron came into the league. Those guys were already making all NBA teams and winning championships and stuff like that. So, you know, a lot of credit has to go to those guys for raising the status of the high school player, as far as saying, well, listen, these guys can play, you know, and these guys deserve to be in the league. So, you know, when LeBron comes into the league, you know, he has the benefit of going to a team that, you know, he can start right away and make a good impact for the team. And let me go ahead and clarify this. Like I said, you know, I don't hate LeBron. I don't like the way he's went about winning championships. And that's why I have excluded him in my top 10. Now, I know people are going to say, well, championships are not everything. Of course, I understand that. You know, Robert Horry is not going to compared to Michael Jordan, no way, shape, or form. You understand what I'm saying? You know, Steve Nash is not going to be better than Magic Johnson. You know, John Stockton is not going to be better than Magic Johnson. You know, not that they've won rings. I'm using a bad example, but I'm just saying, I know championships are not everything. I totally understand that, you know? Or better yet, nobody's going to say Steve Kerr was a better point guard than Magic Johnson, or that there's a debate there, because Steve Kerr was never considered an MVP for the league. But it starts with your finals record. How you perform, it does matter when it comes to the big moments. But like I said, the reason why I don't respect LeBron's championship accomplishments is because he didn't stay within the grind. Okay, he didn't stay in Cleveland to try to duke it out to win a title. He wasn't loyal to the franchise. And let me go ahead and say this, because I know a lot of people, they want to make noise and talk about how, you know, being loyal to the franchise is overrated. Okay, that's not a problem. me personally, I don't have an issue with wherever any player decides to go. If players want to leave their franchise because, in their opinion, and you know, they don't think that they're getting the pieces built around them, and we're talking about superstars, if they don't think that they're getting the team that they want to have built around them, I have no issues with them leaving and going to a different team. I'm more pro player when it comes to that. There's nothing wrong with that. Like LeBron going to Miami, nothing wrong with that. Okay, well, first of all, he fulfilled his contract, but as a free agent, there's nothing wrong with him signing to a different team and not staying loyal. My issue is this, is that when we talk about the all-time greats, how you win and where you went, that matters to your legacy. You know, Patrick Ewing and Michael Jordan were best friends. But guess what? If Patrick Ewing was to go to the Bulls, or if Michael Jordan was to go to the Knicks, their legacy has to suffer. Because they didn't stay within their team. It's like, okay, well, they had to go a different place. Look at Moses Malone. Moses Malone had a terrific career before he went and joined the 76ers to win that 1983 championship. You know, before that, he was already a two-time MVP. He had a finals appearance, which he lost against, was it Boston? I believe they lost to Boston. But I'm just saying that that's the whole thing, is that you can go wherever you want to go, but your legacy is not going to be viewed the same. It's just not, you know, depending on who it is. Now, my whole thing is this, is that when it comes to talking about LeBron, you can't criticize this dude. And that's something that I don't like. And I'm speaking about his fan base because and the reason why I can have this standpoint is because, you know, oh, before I even get to that, if I repeat myself and say a few things that I've said in the first video, just excuse me for that, because I haven't reviewed that video in a while, and I just want to get everything out, but I am going to get to the point of the comparison. I do remember that. I didn't really get to the point of the comparison. I was just a little bit venting, but like I said, when it comes to LeBron, you know, I'm speaking from the point of view where I'm speaking from a reasonable fan base. A reasonable fan or a reasonable supporter of Kobe, where I can, you know, keep it real and be honest about Kobe. Kobe does not belong in the GOAT debate. And I'll say it again. Kobe Bryant does not belong in the GOAT debate. Do I think he's top five? Hell no. Top three? No. Top 10? Absolutely. But I have enough sense to know that he doesn't belong in the GOAT debate. And you know what? I even get sick and tired when I hear people say that, you know, he was the closest thing to Mike. Now, from a style point, as far as how he played the game and his approach, yes, absolutely he was the closest thing to Mike. But when it comes to execution and performing, he was not close to Mike. And that's the major difference. His execution and his timing was not as good as Michael Jordan. So from a style point, yes, he was close to Michael Jordan, but from an execution standpoint, he was not. So hold on 1 second. Okay, I'm back. excuse me for that. But like I was saying, when it comes to these two, damn, I forgot where I was at. Hold on. When it comes to the comparison of Michael Jordan and Kobe, right? Like I said, you know, Kobe Bryant, I have him at number 9. I don't think he belongs in the top 5. I don't think he's 1A, 1B with Michael Jordan. I don't think he's the second greatest player. I don't think he's right behind Mike. Now, yes, I know that there were rumblings of a conversation of can Kobe be on the same level of a Michael Jordan. Now, you know, if was a fifth, you know, and all that other stuff, you know, if ands and buts and all the rest of that, like, yeah, if he would have won that 08 championship as well as 09 and 2010, then yeah, we can have that debate. But he didn't. He won two, making three finals appearances. But like I said, you know, it's not to boost up Kobe Bryant to make him seem like he's just he just trumps a lot of other legends who have done it better than him. And like I said, I grew up on respect. Okay, I grew up on respect, and I don't like the disrespect of the former players, especially like Gilbert Arenas. Okay, this dude, he wants to talk about how Hakeem, you know, is charging people, and he wants to talk about how he's overrated and the dream shit. Like, first of all, dude, you weren't that good when you played. Yeah, like you made a couple of all NBA teams and you made the playoffs, but you didn't make any noise. And another thing, like, Hakeem Olajuwon is a legend in the NBA. Okay, he's a legend. He put a lot of, you know, a lot of time into the game, and he gave back to the game by helping out other players. I remember specifically when Kobe Bryant went to Hakeem Olajuwon, and he was helping, you know, Hakeem was helping Kobe Bryant work on his post moves and stuff like that. And I think this was right after they lost to Boston in 08. You know, I remember that, and his perseverance, you know, it was really good. They went on to win 65 games, and they went on to win the championship, you know? But like I said, it's not to make it seem like Kobe Bryant is just, you know, he is an all-time great, but it's not to put him in the GOAT debate, you know? But anyway, as far as for LeBron, you know, like I said, you know, he comes into the league, he has the green light, and listen, is he, you know, like, he benefits off of, you know, he benefits off of a lot of officiating. He's probably one of the most protected superstars in the game. Like, when you look at the foul calls and stuff like that, like, even with Golden State, they screwed Golden State over. And this goes into a larger point where it's like, this dude gets so much respect on the whistle, him and his team, you know? And then he flops and stuff like that. It's just, like, I can't respect a player that does that. Me, myself, I can't. And like I said, I can't have you in any type of... Look, I look at... Even though I think Will Chamberlain is a better player than LeBron James, but I look at Will and LeBron as being in that same category as far as, like, being, you know, very overrated. You know, because they've had a lot of... They've been on very good teams, even super teams, and they've underachieved. Like, when you look at Will Chamberlain, when he joined with the Lakers back in 1969, they were in the finals every year up until 1973, I want to say. So they were in the finals every year, but they only won one time. No, excuse me. They were in the finals, well, four out of 5 years. One of those years, they lost to the Milwaukee Bucks, who used to be in the Western Conference. And they got eliminated by Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and Oscar Robertson. But besides that, 4 out of 5 years they were in the finals and they only won one title. Now, they was on a super team. You know, that Lakers team was definitely a super team that featured Wilt, Jerry West, and then Elgin Baylor, who would then retire the same season that they won the championship. But yeah, absolutely, that's a super team. Especially when you pair Jerry West, who was absolutely a top five player in the league at the time. And then you add Wilt, who was another top five player in the league at the time as well. So, you know, that right there, that combo is just very lethal. That's why they were in the finals every year. But same thing with LeBron. You know, he goes to Miami, okay, and he underachieves. 2 out of 4 is underachieving, as well as 2 of the most devastating and more infamous finals losses in 2011, which is never gonna escape, and 2014, where they got, you know, absolutely destroyed by San Antonio. So, and another thing, you know, let me go ahead and say this, right? When it comes to the comparison of Kobe versus LeBron, you know, LeBron gets a lot of credit for playing defense, and they say that he could play all 5 positions. No, he cannot. He cannot defend all 5 positions. Excuse me. He cannot. If that was the case, then he would have defended what's this guy's name? He would have defended Dwight Howard back in 09 when they were in the conference finals, but he did not. And it's not about him being undersized, because Dennis Rodman went up against Shaq in 96. Okay? Dennis Rodman was taking on the responsibility of defending a lot of big men back in the Bulls' late 90s dynasty. That late 90s team from 96 to 98, Dennis Rodman was shouldering a lot of the labor of guarding the best big men on the opposite team. Okay? So it's not about a size issue, because if Dennis Rodman can contain and hold Shaq, then what's stopping LeBron from trying to guard and contain Dwight Howard? And matter of fact, let's go with even more recently. Well, what's stopping LeBron from guarding the Joker? I didn't see LeBron guarding Jokic. I didn't see him trying to stop Jokic. So this whole notion of LeBron can defend all five positions, that is a flat out lie, and that is just not true. Now he can defend a certain one. If there's a one, like a point guard that's quicker than him, he cannot stay in front of them. You know what I'm saying? He's not that. His feet is not that fast to shuffle and stay in front of quicker players. He's just not. He doesn't have that quickness. So, he cannot guard ones. Certain twos he can. Threes, I would say he could defend threes pretty well. That's more of his strong suit, even though he does struggle against certain threes that have good handles and have a quick first step, like a Paul George or a Kevin Durant. But other than that, yes, he can defend a lot of threes and twos and some fours, depending on who they are. But all five positions, no, that is a flat-out lie. And let me say this, too. You know, there's a lot of noise being made about Steph Curry being better than Magic Johnson. Now, let me say this, okay? I don't have an issue with people being confident in their abilities. I have no issues with that. And like I always say, you know, LeBron coming out and saying that he's the GOAT, and then on multiple occasions saying that he's the best player in the game. First of all, that's outright not true. And that's very disgusting and very classless. Nobody on this earth determines their legacy. I don't care how good you are. You don't determine how great you were. Other people determine how great you were. You don't determine how you get remembered. Other people determine how you get remembered. You are not in charge of who gets the final say on how great you were. And this is why I respect Michael Jordan, because, you know, he doesn't care about the GOAT debate. He's very secure in himself as a player to know that, listen, you know, I'm certain that he believes he's one of the greatest of all time. Not the greatest, but one of the greatest of all time. There's no doubt in my mind that Michael Jordan believes that. But he has respect for the league enough to say, okay, you know what? There has been players that I haven't played against, so having this discussion is kind of pointless. In which I agree. But it is a fun sports debate and sports talk. It is fun to have that conversation of who would do what in what era and who would be good in this era and that era and stuff like that. It's a fun debate to be had. But there also has to be context and reasoning applied when we're discussing the greatest players of all time. So listen, let me just go ahead and throw this out. When I was, there was a point in time where I thought my video gaming skills were really, really good. You know, not that that really matters a whole lot, but I'm just saying, there was a point in time where I thought that my video game skills were really good, if not the best. That's me. But there has come a point in time where there have been a lot of other gamers that I had to tip my hat and say, man, this guy or this girl, they're very good. You understand what I'm saying? Very good player, just as good as me, you know? But, you know, there's nothing wrong with having confidence, but when Steph Curry comes out and says that he's the greatest point guard, okay, listen, you want to say that, no problem, but you're not the end-all be-all to who gets to determine who's the GOAT point guard, okay? And actually, you're not the greatest point guard. But I'll tell you what, you know what's funny about that? I know what they're doing. Okay, what a lot of people are doing is they're using Steph Curry as a pawn to use that to help LeBron in the GOAT debate. because a lot of people are so phony and so fake that they're not arguing in good faith that Steph is actually the greatest point guard. Because Steph Curry is really a combo guard. He's more of like a Jerry West, in my opinion, who's a combo guard, not a true point, not a true shooting guard, but a combo guard that could do a little bit of everything. But as far as being a pure point guard, where we're talking about passing, setting up the offense, initiating the offense, that is not his forte. He can do that, but that's not really what he does. Draymond Green does that. Draymond Green is essentially the point guard and the initiator of the team. So as far as for him being the greatest point guard, that's incorrect because, you know, by his position, yes, he's point guard by position, but not by play style. But like I said, a lot of people are only using that because they want to say that LeBron had to go up against the greatest team and the greatest dynasty in the Warriors. And what I have to say is that there's no doubt that Golden State is one of the greatest dynasties of all time. No doubt about that. But when we're talking about what happened with LeBron, they lost. And a lot of those games, the teams were close. You know, the teams were very close as far as skill-wise and everything like that. LeBron didn't show up and he didn't perform and he didn't have his guys ready. And this is the biggest reason why I don't have LeBron in my top 10 is because when it came to the final stage, he doesn't have it. I don't care about the regular season MVPs and the finals MVPs and stuff like that. He underachieved on a lot of levels, especially in the finals. Somebody who has a losing finals record cannot be in my top 10, period. Okay? And that's a part of the reason also why I don't have Wilt in my top 10. Because he was getting his ass kicked by Bill Russell and the Celtics. And it's not like they didn't have a chance to win, because one of those years they beat the Celtics to win the championship. So it's not like Wilt was undermanned. No, and people always want to talk about Wilt's stats when it comes to him and Bill Russell. I don't care about those stats. I really don't care about those stats. Because Bill Russell conformed to a system. Wilt Chamberlain could have conformed to a system. But to me, in my opinion, I thought, looking at the stats and by what was said about him, a lot of it was that he was selfish and he wanted to get his numbers. And by you trying to get your numbers, you're going to sacrifice team wins and finals wins. It's all about the team. And you have to find a way to fit yourself within a team system. Can you fit within a team system? Okay? Can you get it done? And LeBron on a lot of levels has not gotten it done. And like I said, and you know what's funny? The funny thing is that, well, they say that the 73-9 Warriors, that was the greatest team ever. Well, then what about the 2017 Warriors? I mean, if that was the greatest team ever and they lost, they lost due to some very fishy circumstances as far as Draymond Green getting suspended, which I didn't like at all. I remember when that happened. That didn't even happen during the game. That happened after the game. You understand what I'm saying? That wasn't a decision that was ruled and made during the game. That was made after everything had finished and they had to quote unquote review it. But, but when it comes to, hold on, I'm drawing a blank here. When it comes to that, why isn't the 2017 Warriors talked about as being the, you know, why is that? Look, they say the 2016 team is the greatest, but they lost. But what about the 2017 team? That means they weren't as great as the 2016 team, but they won. So what does that say about that team? Like, it's easy to just find holes in the whole LeBron James argument of him being the best, because there's just a lot of mistruths and lies. And like I said, Steph Curry is not the greatest point guard ever. And they're only doing that so they can say that LeBron had to go through the best point guard of all time. Just like they're trying to say that Kevin Durant is, not they, but a lot of people, excuse me. I read a lot of stuff online. But a lot of people online also would like to say that Kevin Durant is a better player than Larry Bird, which is insane to me, because we're talking about a man that had to run to Golden State, but apparently he's better than Larry Bird? Yeah, not no chance. And another thing, how is LeBron James the GOAT when he actually wanted to play with Steph Curry? See, and this is what I'm saying about how he wants to team up with everybody. And this is why I don't respect his championship accomplishments, because that's what you play the game for. You play the game to win titles. And we talk about the greatest players that can lead us to a championship. Nobody mentions, now listen, yes, I think certain players who never won a championship, I do think that they have a good chance of leading you to a title. Guys like Charles Barkley, Karl Malone, you know, John Stockton, you know, etc. like that. But at the same time, they never did win. So nobody talks about those guys as far as being the absolute best at their position or in the game, period. So it's all about winning championships. It's not, well, it's mostly, not all, it's mostly about winning championships, being MVP, finals MVP, okay, leading the league in certain categories. It's all, that's what it's all about. All defensive teams, all NBA teams, okay? And I also wanted to say this is that, you know, I always see the same comment. There's a person or people who like to post that whole Bleacher Report thing. Like, screw Bleacher Report. I don't care about what they have to say. And they want to talk about how LeBron is second behind Jordan. That's Bleacher Report's opinion. Who cares what they have to say? Okay? Because a lot of times they don't have no respect for the league anyway. And this goes all back to what I say about Kobe Bryant on why I don't think he's in the GOAT debate, is because I did enjoy watching Kobe Bryant, but I also know that, you know, I don't overrate him as far as what he's done in the league. And I can be honest and say, okay, Kobe Bryant, you know, he does have the most field goals missed. You know, he did play like crap in Game 7 back in 2010. I can be honest and say, okay, you know what? If people want to, you know, he hasn't won a lot of MVPs. If people want to hold that against Kobe Bryant and say he's not in the top 10, then that's fine. And listen, I get a lot of pushback myself for even saying that LeBron James is not a top 10. I get a lot of questions like, oh wow, not top 10? He got to be top 10. No, he does not. Not in my opinion. No, I don't know. He's not no top 10. And not only that, he's the most overrated professional sports athlete in the history of professional sports. And I don't care who has an issue with that. That's my opinion, and I'm standing on that. I'm standing on both of my feet on that. And I'm going to repeat myself. He is the most overrated athlete in professional sports history. I don't give a damn who doesn't agree. I don't care if you don't like it. So what? If you don't like it, and you know, just go ahead and skip the channel. You understand what I'm saying? I don't care. I don't care about your opinion and what you have to say about that. That's my opinion, and I'm sticking to it, because I get sick of the lies and the blatant nonsense when it comes to this guy. Okay? And let me, you know, and like I said, he wanted to play with Steph Curry. So how the hell is he the GOAT? He's always trying to team up with everybody. Just like when he teamed up with Wade, who was a top 5 player in the league, okay? A finals MVP. He was already a Hall of Famer. If his career would have ended in 2010, he was a Hall of Famer, first ballot Hall of Famer. Okay, finals MVP, multiple time All-NBA, multiple time All-Defense. Okay, he was already a first ballot Hall of Famer. No doubt about it, that was a Hall of Fame career. Not many players can say that they had that type of career. Even though the 2006 finals were fishy, but he, you know, they won, whatever. That's what it was. But I don't understand that. He's always trying to team up with everybody and get all the credit. I don't respect that. I don't respect that. Just like Anthony Davis should have won finals MVP in 2020. People want to talk about how Paul Gasol should have won finals MVP in 2010. Well, what the hell did Anthony Davis do in 2020? In the bubble. What did he do in 2020? That whole bubble chip pretty much belonged to Anthony Davis. He was the one putting all the work. Now, excuse me while I drink some water. Yeah, so it is what it is. But also, LeBron back in 2018 said he needed a playmaker. Just more crybaby nonsense. Just like how he said when Rondo came onto the Lakers, he said, oh, you know, Rondo was brought here to lead. Well, what, see, and this is why he's not a good leader. He said out of his own mouth, Rondo was brought to the team to lead. What the hell are you there for? So you're not going to lead the team, but you want somebody else to do it, and then you're going to get all the credit? I don't think so. It's not happening, bro. So, you know, and then on top of that, you know, D-Wade came out recently and said that, you know, that whole Miami team was to stop Kobe Bryant. And this is why Kobe Bryant's legacy has to be respected. And this is why I'm talking about LeBron in the fashion that I'm talking about, because I don't respect how he's went about doing things. And this is another reason why. They built that super team to stop Kobe Bryant, even though they got stopped by Dirk Nowitzki and the Mavs, and he got swept. But also, LeBron, they built that team so they could stop Kobe. And another thing, like I said, with that channel, they like to post a lot of stuff with Bleacher Report, and they don't like to be honest about Kobe Bryant, okay, and LeBron James. They like to say, oh, you know, he has more points and stuff like that, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, well, let's talk about how LeBron got swept in 3 different decades in the finals. Let's talk about, you know, and they want to put up there that Kobe Bryant has the most misses in NBA history. LeBron has the most turnovers in NBA history. And if he's not careful after this season, LeBron is going to have the most misses in NBA history. So won't you think about that? For all this talk about how he's a pass-first player, he sure likes to shoot and brick a lot. And another thing, I don't respect his play style either, because not only does he get the most respect on the whistle, he likes to bully people out of the way. Well, I don't even say that, because Shaq is more of a bully than he is. But Shaq used to bully people. But LeBron, he likes to offensive foul people out of the way with his elbow and stuff like that, and they never call it. And LeBron only averages like 20-something percent outside of, like, from the mid-range. LeBron is a horrible jump shooter from the mid-range. I don't know if people know that. So if he had to rely on his jump shot, which he doesn't, he's very, very suspect. He's gotten away with relying on his athletic ability for all of these years. Okay? And there's nothing wrong with that. But also, you've been the media darling. You've been the most protected athlete. You don't have a stake in the claim of being the GOAT because of those circumstances. And I don't care who gets mad at that. I'm just being honest, and I'm keeping it real. You don't have no stake into that claim. But anyway, I just wanted to say that, you know. And listen, this, and plus on top of that, this whole NBA era is soft and it's garbage. Damian Lillard wants to go to the Milwaukee Bucks. And I was speaking about Damian Lillard. And this is the issue with today's NBA. Nobody wants to compete. Everybody wants to join up and then say they're the greatest. They're this, they're that. It's like, oh, and let me also say this. You know what? Like, there's a lot of disrespectful idiots out there. Let me talk about Spencer Dinwiddie. You know, this guy had a nerve to say, if you put me in the 60s and 70s, I would be LeBron James. Bro, you're not even LeBron James in this era. So what the hell are you even talking about? I'm talking about some, if you drop me in the, because I'm 6'6", 240. You know, if you drop me in that era, I would be LeBron. Dude, shut the hell up. You're not even a LeBron in this era. So how the hell can you be LeBron in that era? And this goes all in part to the disrespect of the old school players. And I don't have that mentality. Okay? I don't. There's a lot of past players that can play in today's NBA, and vice versa. There's a lot of players that can play in past league. Okay? It's not exclusive to one or the other. So I just get sick and tired of hearing that nonsense. And people don't want to say nothing about that. They just let it go. Like, people don't want to, you know, be critical of that and disagree. You got people agreeing with that nonsense. And it's just, it's really disgusting, because, like I said, I grew up on respect. I grew up on respecting the past players and respecting their legacy and their accomplishments. Okay? I don't care who it is. Just like how J.J. Redick was to call people back then plumbers and firemen, and he was having nerve to disrespect Bob Cousy. Well, guess what Bob Cousy was that you weren't? Not only was Bob Cousy a champion, Bob Cousy was actually an MVP. Something that you weren't, J.J. Redick. Okay? Something that you never were and never will be. Because you are a one-dimensional player. All you did was shoot threes. That's all you were good for. So don't talk no junk about Bob Cousy, who was the MVP and a multiple-time champion. You better have some damn respect. All right? I don't agree with that. And another thing. Let me just say this real quick, and then this is going to be my final note and my final nail in the coffin when it comes to this whole thing. You know, the reason why I don't like when people say, you know, LeBron needs help and all the rest of the stuff. I was listening to a segment about Patrick Mahomes. This was probably about a month and a half ago. And I remember, they would have a conversation. Does Patrick Mahomes need another weapon? And this is what I don't like. I'm tired of superstars getting the passes of, oh, well, does this player need this and need that? When they won the Super Bowl, I specifically remember saying that Patrick Mahomes is a superstar. Like, he's a legit superstar and the best player in football. Okay? He's the best player in the league, the most dynamic, the most clutch. He's the best player in the game today, Patrick Mahomes. Okay? Regardless what their record is, when he needs to turn on the Jets, he puts on the pressure. Patrick Mahomes is the best football player in the game today, bar none. Okay? But one thing I'm not going to do is I'm not going to say that he needs more weapons. No, you get it done with who you have on your team. And this is why I don't like when people talk about LeBron. Oh, he needs more help. He needs this. He needs a playmaker. I don't respect that because it's like, why can't you get it done with the players that are already there? Why? Why you can't elevate the talent? You know, Larry Bird, when he first went to the Boston Celtics, they had the same team, and they ended up winning over 60 games. They won 20-something games the season, made no changes to the roster. He comes along, and they win 60 games. The same thing with Jason Kidd and the Nets. They made a trade for Jason Kidd by trading Stephon Marbury going to Phoenix. Jason Kidd comes to the team. No other changes to the team. They went from 20-something wins to 50 wins. Why can't he just play with the people that are on the team? Why is it always, oh, he needs this, he needs that? This is why I don't respect him, and I don't respect his fan base. Because he facilitates that. Talking about, oh, we need a playmaker. Well, what the hell are you there for? Oh, this guy was brought in to lead. What are you there for? You never heard Kobe Bryant say anything like that. And also the excuses when he loses is just disgusting. But anyway, listen. You know, LeBron is not a better defender than Kobe Bryant. LeBron is not a better scorer. He's not a better shooter. Okay? He's not better than the clutch. It's close, but I'm giving the edge to Kobe. Okay? He's damn sure not a better defender. He's not a better leader. All right? There's a bunch that Kobe Bryant has in his favor. Okay? And he never was on a team that three-peated in the finals. Okay? He was never on a team that made a three-peat. Kobe Bryant was being with Shaq. Even if he was the second best player, I don't care. He was on a team that was on a three-peat. Okay? And let's stop all this nonsense about Steph Curry being the greatest point guard. If you're using that to boost up LeBron James, you are really a sad individual. Because that's all I hear is, you know, people talk about how Steph is this, Steph is that. And Steph needs to shut the hell up also. Okay? You don't determine your legacy. Now, I like Stephen Curry just as much as the next person. But I'm not going to allow Steph Curry to get away with speaking that nonsense. Okay? And you don't get to determine how great you are. Now, if it's a question of you and another player, and you want to say that you're the better player, fine. But you're not the end-all, be-all to be saying that. There's nothing wrong with thinking that you're better than Magic Johnson. But guess what? In reality, you're not better than Magic Johnson. And it's not even close. So that's all I have to say. That's just the part two of the debate of the whole thing. Kobe Bryant will always be better than LeBron. And ain't no debate in my opinion. But anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and get this game in, and then what I'm gonna do is I got another surprise for y'all, cause I ain't been here in a minute. So let's do it, man. Let's see who we got. So they got Kenyon Martin, Yao, and Steve Francis. We're gonna go with Diesel, Tim Duncan, and Diesel, Duncan. Matter of fact, let's go with my boy, man. We gotta do it, man. Kobe Bryant, one of the realest. Let's get busy. Now, one of my favorite courts is Foster Beach, but we're gonna go to let's go to Mosswood. No game breaks. Let's get it. Anyway, I hope you all enjoy. Like I said, man, listen. You can agree, you can disagree. It's fine. I'm open to all opinions, all comments. It's not an issue for me. You know, I'm not gonna block or as long as you don't get disrespectful. You know, I'm not gonna delete or block your comment. You know, you can weigh in on the debate and what you think. And if you're a LeBron supporter and you think he's the greatest ever, or you think he's better than Kobe, then it is what it is. I'm not trying to change anybody's opinion. I'm just gonna state my opinion. If you agree, fine. If you disagree, that's okay as well. But I'm just speaking on how I evaluate players. And like I said, LeBron will never, ever be in my top 10. Not even close. And that's a wrap for that. But anyway, Mr. Clutch, Jerry West is on the screen. Shout out to Jerry, the logo. Who shouldn't be the logo. Okay, I think Bill Russell should be the logo. But it is what it is. But anyway, let's get right into it. Bobito, take it away. Oh wait, oops, I had the interactive playlist on. Here we go. Let's turn this up a little bit. By switching that out, I put the other playlist on. Let's get it though. I ain't played this in a minute. That's good. Kobe from the range. Give me that.
A can of worms. He cannot be stopped.
Kobe showing the moves.
I can't look.
Ooh, the Diesel. Ooh, the Diesel. Jack Diesel.
Ooh,
give me that.
Oh man.
Oh, good rip.
See, looks great. It's like that, y'all. It's like that, y'all. It's like that or that. It's like that, y'all. Coming down.
Ooh, wow. He's dunking on Shaq? That's crazy. That's crazy. Ooh. Boy, Yao Ming got like a 2 for power.
Was a feast, y'all.
Kobe Bryant attacking the basket. We have 4-1 right here.
Steal the shot.
Oh, the steal. The rip, with the layup. Oh,
but not close.
Of course, Shaq blows the layup and then the steal.
Man, you got, ooh, you looking like you got a receding hairline. Just bury your head. Racking up the puntos.
That's right, Big Diesel in the building. Let's get it. Give me that.
Got a bad taste in my mouth.
Kobe Bryant going to the basket. Shout out to my dude, man. Rest in peace, man. One of the best to ever do it right there.
Yes. Yes. Affirmative. Yes. He did do
Stevie.
That.
Stevie. Stevie franchise in the building. We're winning 6-2 right now. Oh, Duncan! Take a look at that one again. Slam dunk, baby. Today's a really good day. Hope you all are doing well. Happy Monday to you all. Hope you had a good weekend. You know what I'm saying? It's really good to be back.
Hey, man.
I've been busy.
The point is not to let him block your shot.
Oh, go to the basket. Oh! Oh, he stole the ball. But anyway, yeah, it's good to be back, man. It's good to be uploading again.
You're not doing it correctly. Will you please give it to someone that can handle the ball? Kenny Martin. Look at that's me. That's a mean machine.
Kenny Martin. Kobe in the building. Oh, let's get it.
Trick tricks. The question.
Give me that.
Why would you try to shoot on him? You just got
Kobe showing the moves. Gives it up to Shaq. Cannot be stopped right there. Big Diesel in the building. Must have the steal right there. Get him out of the air.
Me? Yeah, you. Who told you can put the ball on the floor?
Kobe Bryant going up for the slam. Bang. As he gets pushed out of the way at the end.
Should I be? I mean, really, you don't need to be that hard on him. Woo! I like that move. I'm still on that one. And he wipes.
Oh, he blocks it. Oh my goodness.
Steal.
Okay. Get that out of here. From Duncan to Diesel. 11-5, we up right now. No game breakers. You ain't gonna see no game breakers today. What you will see is some good basketball being played.
You gonna let him do you like that?
As Francis makes the move and gives it up to Yao. Hey, Yao.
Oh! I just fell out my seat.
Kick pass, Oh, Kobe from deep. Oh, and he gets blocked from Yao.
D is the fourth.
The slam from Steve Francis.
D, would you mind using it? Oh!
He's just too good.
It's a beautiful thing. No doubt. Ooh,
that was right there.
Right there, boy.
Trying to get close to that one to block it. I was right there. Kobe Bryant with the slam once again. I'm winning 12-8 right here. Ooh, almost had the steal. Get it out of here.
It's hard to score. You got the shot up, but you.
Oh, Kobe. Oh, good block from Chow. He jumped up so high. Oh, here we go. Here we go.
That looks like an old video game.
Oh, man. Y'all blocks it again. Oh, giving it to Duncan. This game is so much fun to play. Really? Oh, get it back here.
I'm in the live.
Duncan. What a pass from Kobe. Making a move on Yao. Finishing it off with the slam dunk. Hopefully I'll be able to stream sometime this week.
See, boys and girls out there, that's how you're supposed to express yourself. That's
no. Oh, that's BS right there. But he made a good shot for Francis. With the defense all in his face.
That's how you can use that? Nah, I'm just bugging out, big ass.
There we go. Kobe. And it goes in from long range. Kobe Bryant showing the range.
You have an option.
Oh man, what a block from Duncan. then they got the steal.
Now, if that was me on defense, I just walk off the court. That ball.
Oh, man.
Lost and found. Man on destruction.
As Francis takes it to the basket, we win it 16-12.
Excuse me, does the concrete feel hot today? Because you're on the ground right now.
Timmy Duncan. With the baldy. Oh, give me that. Kobe.
Carry on.
Oh, he misses it.
Carry on.
Another chance from deep. And it goes in. Cannot leave that brother open. It's almost getting. Yeah, it's getting point right now. 19-13. Can we hit something from half court with Kobe?
The hazard.
From the, and he airballs it. Oh no, I didn't mean to shoot from right there. Here we go from half court. From half court. Oh no, not even close.
MCs are jumping out, shoes are socks.
Oh yeah, making moves. That's more. That's a move by Yao, he ain't playing.
Oh. What a pass!
Oh. The steal from Francis, and then he goes up with the dunk. That was nice right there.
Oh, he just got shook.
Oh, man.
This is not gonna be your day.
Give me that.
The J-U-Ites.
From the logo.
It's a good chance.
No good.
Gone out of here. Oh, yeah. Tipo.
From half court. Oh. From half court. Kobe Bryant. Taps the head at the end of the Adios. Game. Oh no. No, he didn't. As the NBA stars defeat more NBA stars. 21-15. Shout out to all these ballers in the game. What a game. Kobe dropping 13. Hey, that's going to do it for this one. I'm going to be right back though. I got another surprise for y'all. You know what I'm saying? I got another extra recording. But in closing, like I said, LeBron's championship accomplishments, in my opinion, are not to be respected. Okay, he's had a lot of ifs, ands, and buts, and all the rest of that stuff. More than anybody in NBA history. But it is what it is, man. Whether you have him as the GOAT, top 5, top 10, doesn't matter to me. It's your opinion. I have mine. He'll never be in my top 10. It is what it is. But just wanted to make a part 2 and clarify a few things. You know, only thing LeBron really has on Kobe is he can pass the ball better. And he has a few better Game 7 performances. But as a whole, yeah, he doesn't stack up to Kobe Bryant. So, it is what it is. But anyway, that's going to do it for this one. I'll be right back with the next video. So, I'm out of here, everybody. See ya!